Hello there, this is Mari Smith, and in today's edition, we're going to be talking all about how to increase your blog traffic with social media share buttons. And at the end, I'll share one of my hot marketing tips.
Welcome to Social Media Examiner TV with your host, Mari Smith.
So the cool thing about adding social media share buttons to your blog and website is that your visitors can share your content, your blog posts, your site, your pages, all over the internet on their social profiles like Facebook and Twitter and LinkedIn without leaving your site. So first we'll talk about the TweetMeme button. You've probably seen that around the internet on different blogs, and it's the one that has the little counter and below that little green retweet button. And you can decide how that actually pre-populates the tweet. When people click on it and it goes out to Twitter, you can actually say, you know, format that the way that you want it. It's a WordPress plugin. The beauty of it is you've got your live counter. You could instead, or as well, have the Twitter's own button, which you can get from their Twitter site, and you can position it vertically or horizontally or with no counter, with or without a counter. You might choose to put the Twitter button, say, on your blog somewhere, and you could have a command or a call to action that says, you know, tweet this blog, and someone could just say, hey, you know, I found a great blog to read, come and check it out. Now, the Facebook like button, one of my most favorite social plugins. In April of 2009, Facebook changed the whole internet forever when they actually made the like button available throughout the internet. Previous to that, it was only on their website. And you might remember the Facebook fan pages used to say, become a fan. And in April of 2009, they changed that to like, and it was the same time that that like button became available throughout the internet. So you can add it to your blog, and you want to actually position it at the top and bottom. I think that's the best way to do it. And you can have it so it displays the little avatars of any of the person's friends, and you get that wonderful social proof. So you see, oh, look, John and Joe and Mary like this post. Well, I'm feeling more compelled to click the like button. Now, what happens when a person clicks that like button, it actually automatically posts over onto Facebook on their Facebook personal profile and gets you that additional coveted visibility. You can actually edit the way that the plugin shows up, and you can have it so that it opens up and allows for a little comment to go in, and that comment actually posts over onto Facebook too. You can change the verb from like to recommend. So what I like to do is on you put at top and bottom of each post the like button, and then you could have a recommend button over at top right, let's say, of your blog. And what people are doing essentially is recommending your whole blog. Now you can go to developers.facebook.com/plugins, and that's where you'll find all of Facebook's social plugins, including that like button. Or you could add just the WordPress, if you just Google WordPress Facebook like button plugin, and you'll get it from there. So along with the Facebook like button, which you really for sure need to add to your blog, there's the Facebook share button, and that actually has that wonderful recognizable little blue button that says share, and then you can position it anywhere you want on your site and next to the different blog posts, top, bottom, or just bottom, and it will actually have the counter so you can see how many times people have shared, and it gives that wonderful social proof. It doesn't have the little images, the friends images like the like button, but still with that counter going up, it does have that compelling, whoa, this must be popular, so I'm going to share it with my friends too. Now what happens is that when you click on that share button, up pops a separate window that's already got the link and a little preview of the post and an image, and then that person can put their own little comment and then click share, which will go ahead and post onto their personal profile. Okay, so we also have a fairly new addition to the whole share button family, and that's LinkedIn. And the LinkedIn works almost exactly like Facebook, and you can have different versions, the horizontal or the vertical or with no count. I recommend putting the count in, unless, I can't think of a reason why you wouldn't want to, but put the count button in there. And when people click on that share on LinkedIn, up it pops, this little pre-populated message, and you can actually write your own little comment, and off it goes to your LinkedIn peeps. So the DiggDigg plugin is a WordPress plugin, and it's a collection of little buttons that you can share on the different social profiles. You've maybe seen it on Mashable.com. And you can have a version where it floats down the page as you're scrolling down a blog post. This collection of share buttons floats down with you. And you can have Facebook and Twitter and share on LinkedIn, the new one, and Google Buzz and all the different social bookmarking sites like Digg and StumbleUpon and Delicious. You can have it in the floating version or a compact version at the top of each post or the bottom of each post. So check out DiggDigg. Maybe you'll want that one instead of all the others. One of my favorite WordPress plugins is called Sexy Bookmarks. And what that does is add a whole row of buttons that will pop up as you mouse over them down at the bottom of every post. Really easy to install and configure, and you have a choice of up to 85 different social sites. Who knew there were that many? I don't recommend you have all that many, it's too many. But have maybe one row of the top 6 or 8, Facebook and Twitter and LinkedIn, and then you can even have, there's one for email. People can share the post with their friends through email. And hover over it, you'll see they pop up like toast. It's really kind of fun, and it's very recognizable. You might have seen it on sites like socialmediaexaminer.com has it. I have it on my own site, marismith.com. So that's Sexy Bookmarks. For sure want to add that Wibiya toolbar to your website, and that puts this wonderful little ribbon down at the bottom. You've probably seen it on Social Media Examiner's website, I have it my own. And what that does, it allows your visitors to your website to interact with your different social profiles without leaving your site. So for example, when they click the Twitter button, up pops it's a little pane with your latest tweets, and people can reply to them and retweet you and tweet to you. Same thing with Facebook, up pops your Facebook fan page, a little mini version in a pane where people can click like and comment, add their posts. YouTube as well, you could have your latest YouTube videos pop up, and this is all within the toolbar without leaving your site. There's another feature where you can have your whole blog translated into another language at the click of a button, and it's instant. And in the back end for you, remember this is totally free to add to your site, you can go into your back end dashboard and you can see all these great stats, and really, really helpful seeing who's coming to your site and for how long and what's referred them there. Wonderful analytics. So that's the Wibiya toolbar, and check it out and add it to your site. So today's hot marketing tip is to make sure that you offer the opportunity for your visitors to your blog to subscribe by email. Building your own email list is a very, very important component of your marketing. Email marketing is still very much alive and kicking. And some studies are showing that people will subscribe to a blog more by email than they will RSS feed. With the RSS feed, popular ones are like Google Reader or Yahoo and a lot of the different mobile ones. For the iPad, there's Flipboard and Pulse. But here's the thing. On Social Media Examiner, what Mike uses here is called AWeber. It's AWeber, and that will allow you to actually get people to opt in to get your daily blog posts or however often you're blogging, and you can then do broadcasts to those same people. That is a paid service versus likes of FeedBurner, which is free, it's owned by Google, and you can burn a feed and have people subscribe by RSS feed or email. But you might want to check out aweber.com and get people to subscribe and opt in, and you can even have popovers and all kinds of cool stuff to increase your email marketing. So thanks for watching. If you liked today's episode, go ahead and leave your comments below and share it on Facebook and share on Twitter. We have a hashtag, it's #SMETV. We'll see you next time.
This episode is sponsored by Blogging Success Summit 2011.